Ako, may tanong ako. Time out. May tanong ako sa'yo, pare.
Sige.
I have a very simple question. Paano mo sasagutin? Sino ka?
Sino ako? Teka. Okay guys, welcome back to Stokoyan at nandito tayo ngayon with Direk Jordan. Siya ang nag-direct ng Art of Legal na aabangan nyo. Solid yun. Okay.
Boss.
So, before this, nag-usap na kami about things, about what's happening with the industry right now. So, right now, we're gonna talk about the VTRs.
Mm-hmm.
Paano ka mag-screen ng tamang talento para sa tamang eksena at pelikula?
Mm. Actually, I'm actually talking about this kasi yung experience namin casting people for the film project, Art of Ligaw. So we went to Davao, ang daming talents that were needed. And then even in Manila, we were shooting in bars, may mga eksena with girls, with men and all these things. And nahirapan kami kasi yung talents that would come to us, parang they appeared without character and identity. So kami, as producers, as casters, as people who decide who gets into the film or not, parang ang daming time and energy na na-waste trying to call or parang get ano ba yung character nito? Kasi trying lahat magaganda eh.
Trying to find the right fit, diba?
Oh. And I think talents out there who want to get into the industry are not equipped properly so that ma-cut out nila lahat ng mga excess BS on and let the producers and decision makers know who they really are and their character.
Yes, exactly. Kung sino man yung nasa project na yun.
I think yung pinaka-challenge sa talents who want to get into the industry, ha? Parang I think what they should be able to concern themselves first and foremost is not to get the project or the role immediately.
Yeah,
hindi
role.
Secondary yun eh. The first that they should be involving themselves should be strengthening and really owning up to an identity.
Of themselves.
So there's character that is needed and then there's their identity. Most of the time, I think this is counter to how people think and everything. Ah.
Yeah, that's common in the industry.
Pero people always go for the character.
Yeah.
Pina-prioritize na yung character.
Because they have to portray that.
Yeah. And then, let go of their identity. Ang babaw ng character na nilalabas nila either sa pictures or sa video.
Kasi hindi sila yun.
Oh. And they didn't have the proper preparations and internalizations to get into that character.
Mm-hmm.
You get? So, para sa akin, kunyari, wala ka talagang time to prepare for that character, ilabas mo yung identity mo, ipasok mo dun sa character. You get? Does this make sense?
Yeah, no. Kasi, everyone is talking about content, but they don't know about the context.
Mm, yeah.
You sinasabi mo context yun, which is about their identity.
Yeah.
Yun eh. So you're given this character, pero nagmo-morph ka into that character, which is not you. So they tend to let go of their identity.
Yes.
Therefore, they're not the character.
Yep. They present a character that is so superficial and mediocre.
Yeah, kasi it's not them.
So ako, what I advise is yun nga, a lot of people when they break in, they want to present themselves as versatile. I can do different characters and all of that. Meron naman talagang kaya yun. Pero that's really ang tindi ng galing mo, skill set mo, tsaka talent mo to be able to do that.
Yeah, para maging fit ka sa lahat ng characters.
Wow. And even if you're so talented and gifted at that, it still needs preparation eh. Diba?
Of course.
So, ang sa akin, is instead of also focusing on that, also focus on, actually, ito yung problema ng a lot of people or artists, they tend to neglect developing their identity.
Because they're all focused on getting that character.
That character or getting that, and they portray this particular character. Hindi lang sa pelikula, in terms of social media. People want those ratings, they want those views, they want those posts that will go viral and everything. And hinahabol nila yung what their concept is of of what will be viral or
not. Hinahabol nila yung impression.
Yeah,
yung impression. The impression of what they are, which is somehow they're not. Diba? Kasi parang, diba, like when you go to a VTR, the requirement is that ikaw ang kontrabida na mahilig magdroga, na mahirap ang pamilya. Let's say ganun lang, inano ko lang. Pero pagdating mo doon, nag VTR ka, pero social ang kinalakihan mo. But then again, that's not your identity.
Which one? The
character.
The character.
The character.
Okay.
So pumasok ka, iba identity mo. Pero hindi mo na-implement or na-gel sa character na kailangan. Kasi 'di ba, pag may identity ka, 'yun yung identity mo. Kung iba ang character mo, iba 'yun. Pero medyo mahirap 'yun, eh, no? You somehow gel it with the character.
Yes, yes. But when you really think about it, meron akong dalawang talents pumasok.
Okay.
Isa jologs na jologs.
Isa social.
Isa social. Uh-huh. Pero yung character, sabi mo, jologs na addict na ano.
Yeah.
Yan yung ano.
Ano yung role?
Yun nga, jologs na addict.
Yun yung role.
Uh-huh. Okay. Uh-huh. Ngayon, dalawa yung talents. Isa talagang totoong jologs. Uh-huh. Isa social.
Uh-huh.
They interpret it both with the identity that they have.
Yeah.
Not necessarily itong character na to will automatically get this, eh.
Yes.
You know why? Because this social guy, if he stucks with his identity yet portrays the role, brings in a dimension that is unexpected. That's fresh, which is interesting.
Interesting.
And ako as a director and directors always looks for something that is fresh.
Yes.
If you come to me and I see something expected, okay. Alright, noted. Pero you come in, you fulfill the and yet bring something so fresh that I myself wasn't able to imagine in the first place. Yeah. Mas gusto ko to.
So let's
that
say,
excites me as
so
a creative person.
So let's say itong social na tao na to, poging-pogi. Itong isang other character na to, which fits well sa character na to. This identity, which fits well sa character na yun. Pasok na pasok. But this guy is very social.
And
hindi, pag tinignan mo initially, doesn't fit the character, pero portrays it well.
Uh-oh.
So pasok na pasok yun. In terms of visual, mas pasok siya compared sa tao na...
Depende sa objective ng director. Uh-oh. But you can never know what the objective of the director is.
Yes, kasi pwede mo sabihin na, tayo na, sobrang pogi na itong character nito, pero it fits well with the
character.
Sobrang pogi ng identity na to, but it fits well with the character.
Yep. So, ako ngayon, if I were this guy, this guy, say the guapo, konyo guy,
compared to the natural guy.
Hindi ko man siya, ako director, gusto ko talaga jolong. Pero, because he stuck to his guns, his identity, magsistick sa akin ngayon itong guy na to. Yung sa utak ko lang, sa consciousness ko. May iba pa akong projects.
So, pwede siyang hindi niya makuha yung role, pero pasok siya sa ibang role.
Oo, kasi nagmarka siya eh.
Parang kunyari, Aga Mulak na mahirap, na nag-driver ng jeep. Tapos kinuha niya si Diana Arantores na sobrang,
yung mga ganang movie. Exactly. So you can never really tell. So that's why, when you go into a project, you'd never let go of the identity.
Yeah.
And the thing is, it's a basic principle. Artistry is really the oxymoron or the combination of universality and uniqueness. Artists always want to be both. They want to be universal, pero at the same time, they want to be unique. They want to be unique, pero at the same time, they want to be different, but at the same time, they want to be universal. There's no artist in the true, authentic, sincere artist that doesn't want to be universal. I mean, yes, they want to be, to stick to a particular genre or a particular audience, pero at the end of the day, in the heart and soul of every artist, they want to impact as many people as possible. That's universality. Yet, they want to stick to their uniqueness. That's struggle.
Universality compared to uniqueness and character compared to identity.
And that's the paradox or the paradox of an artist. So, and how do you do that? How can you be unique and universal at the same time? Actually, when you are so unique, when you dig deep inside your identity and your uniqueness, you actually get to the point where you are actually so universal because it connects to everyone. Like Bob Marley. Bob Marley is one of the most...
Para maintindihan na lang. Kasi medyo di ko rin nakuha ng konti.
Like, Bob Marley is one of the most unique musicians, artists of all time. Tama?
Yeah.
Unique. I mean, unique. A Jamaican who speaks broken English,
Not necessarily reggae. About his genre.
Yeah. And then, he's so unique. And his voice is so unique. And yet, when he sings, his songs...
May laman.
May laman. And it impacts whatever genre, whatever economic strata, whatever intelligence, whatever education you have, wherever country you come from, it impacts, his songs impacts you. Yeah. So how can something so unique...
And universal.
And at the same time, universal. Diba? So that's it. Parang the people think when they run after universality, they have to let go of their uniqueness. Hindi eh. You go after your uniqueness, which is your individuality, which is your dignity, which is your one, your own soul, your own essence. And when you get deep into the core of that essence, actually that core is actually so connected to everyone. Then you become universal.
Alam mo, dahil sa Bob Marley, nag-gets ko siya.
Yeah.
Kasi is so unique, but what he is doing is so universal.
Yep.
Diba? But then again, he's a combination of uniqueness and universal.
Mm. And that's what we want naman talaga at the end of the day. When you break it down to the bottom line, that's what we want as artists. That's what we want either as an actor, or as a filmmaker, as a musician, as a painter. That's what we want.
So this applies to everything. Like, kunyari, sa mga nag-VTR. When you go to a VTR, you're not just only unique, but you're also universal.
That's your objective, to be both unique and universal.
Yeah.
As you portray that character.
As you portray that character.
So, tanong, how do you do that? And, yun na, and the dilemma of a lot of artists, especially a lot of Filipinos who do not have an identity, we tend to run away from our identity. Para sa akin, example. Yeah, the new Joker.
The new Joker.
The new Joker.
Joker movie.
Si Joaquin, di ba? Joaquin Phoenix. Ngayon, with Joaquin Phoenix, one of the most brilliant artists of our time. Took on this challenge of Joker. But you could see, he gave himself up in that character. Kasi I've seen almost all of the films of Joaquin Phoenix. Walang nag-portray ng deformity niya eh. Diba? Parang, doon pa rin. Walang,
which is his uniqueness.
Which is his uniqueness, man. His deformity.
Yes. Yun yung uniqueness
niya. Ibang tao that are not secured with their identity would run away from that deformities. Yeah. The insecurity yun eh.
Nagamit yung identity niya.
Oo, sa kanya, hindi niya tinakbuhan yun. I'm not running away from my deformities or my weaknesses or my flaws because that is the wholeness of who I am. And tao, because of social media, have a tendency, gusto nila itago yung mga weaknesses nila, yung mga flaws nila and everything. Pero if you're really, I think the point of the artist is being able to embrace all those weaknesses and celebrate in them as part of your identity. And when we're able to do that, we're going to be able to generate a kind of confidence that every expression that we do, yun, is a point of universality and uniqueness.
So, Direk Jordan is here with us right now. Puta slur. Slur na ako. Okay.
Yari ka sa akin.
So, maraming salamat ulit sa Barrick, sa Chipcheria. So, again, this is Tokoyan. In-interview natin ngayon si Direk Jordan. And, Direk Jordan.
Boss.
Let us know more about Art of Ligaw.
Actually, ang ganda nung context nung pinag-usapan and the movie The Art of Ligaw. Ligaw kasi is... two words in Filipino. It means two things. One is courtship and the other is ligaw, lost.
Exactly.
So a lot of people are lost right now because they don't know who they are. And itong pelikulang to, yes, it's about love, pero it's also about being lost.
Tama. Nalost ako nung kainin.
So the art of ligaw is actually the art of courtship and the art of being lost. And sometimes we think it's wrong to be lost. Actually, para sa akin, it's actually beautifully majestic to be lost. Kasi when you're lost, that's really the time that you find yourself.
parang meme, parang like, Instagrammable yan, Instagrammable. Pero that's
So it's ano, it stars ano, it shot, it was shot almost entirely in Mindanao, in Davao. And it stars Epi Quizon and KZ Tandingan. So yun, we're in editing stage. Right, yeah. We shot everything.
Kailan natin maabangan to?
I believe September-ish.
Binibenta
natin siya sa ano, sa mga binibenta namin sa mga ano ngayon, sa mga studios and distributors. We're talking to two solid distributors right now. Pero also we're also talking to video streaming platforms.
Like
Video City.
Video City, right tayo na VHS.
Luma eh.
Pero guys, seryoso. Abangan niyo tong Art of Legal as in title pa lang. 'Di ba? Baka makatulong sa inyo kung mahanap niyo man yung identity niyo or character. Pero ano bang difference ng identity sa character?
Identity is who you are, character is what you project. Yeah.
Exactly. Sir. Alam mo? Kay Direk Jordan, puro kwento lang narinig ko siya. Sa totoo lang. Kasi before, bago lang naman ni Kuku. Iba ka mag-isip the dreamer ka talaga. Iba ka. I mean.
Thank you.
Dami ko natutunan.
Thank you for having me, man.
So, para i-end tong ano na to, ng series at episode to, dapat tanungin ko siya kung ano yung tatanong niya sa akin. Kasi tinanong niya sa akin, hindi ko nasagot eh. Direk, tanong mo ulit ngayon.
What's your dream, pare?
What's my dream? Ang hirap nga, no? What's my dream? Ang hirap nga. The fact na nag-isip ako, my dream is, shit, ang hirap. Sobrang nakainom na ako. Alam mo, ang dream ko lang ito, dito sa office ito, gusto ko pa siyang lumaki. Gusto ko siya maging warehouse. I'm being honest, gusto ko siya maging warehouse. Gusto ko magawa lahat ng gusto ko in terms of production, storytelling, video, and I think na makakatulong kayo sa amin. Na thank you for being here with us right now. And I hope na hindi ito yung last. And makagawa pa tayo ng maraming content or whatever porn, it is porn, that we...
Porn?
Pwede. Sige. And whatever it is, but to be honest, this is my life. Production industry, storytelling, I wanna create anything.
Gusto ko yan.
Gusto mo yan, di ba?
Gusto ko yan.
Okay, yeah. Guys. See you next week. Hey. Tanginang hirap pala nito.
Ito para sa'yo, pare. Okay. Spoken word. This is called the Dreamer's Manifesto.
Ready.
State your name.
Arnel Riodique.
Choose to live a life of adventure. I, Jordan Sebastian, choose to live a life of adventure, excitement, joy, spontaneity, and love. I choose to love, and as I love, I live. As I live, I give. As I give, I serve. As I serve, I step closer to the reality of my dreams. I will dream. I will dream big and amazing and spectacular and awesome dreams. And I will live my dreams and not compromise for the sake of security, safety, or comfort. I will jump out of my comfort zone and embrace change. Change whom I feared, change whom I did. I will seek to live beyond what I can, believing that the God whom I trust is much, much bigger and greater than any obstacle I may face. I will face my fear. I will stop running away from it and turn around. And when I'm face to face and eye to eye with it, I will grab the bull by its balls and make it scream surrender. I surrender. I surrender to my great destiny, knowing deep in my heart, I'm destined for greatness. I'm destined for excellence, not mediocrity, not conformity, not in arrogance, but with the mantle of humility placed upon me. Because this is not about me. This is about humanity, who need men and women inflamed with compassion that will ignite the hearts of timid and fearful souls to reach on and soar higher. And I will do all this not 10 years from now when I'm free, not 5 years from now when I'm ready, not 1 year from now when all is steady, not 1 month from now when I have the money, not 1 week from now when I know how, not even tomorrow, because tomorrow is far from now. I will live my dreams now. I will act now. Thank you very much.
Sir Budoy, Sir Jordan, I hope we have
more collaborations
together, and thank you.
All right.
Gusto niyo yan, di ba? Gusto ko yan. Yeah.